Hello, dear children. How are you all? I hope all are fine. Stay home, stay safe. In our last class, we had a discussion on sandwich theorem and important results. And the results are, whenever limit extends to 0 of sin x divided by x, sin x divided by x is equal to what we have the result? 1. Similarly, limit as x approaches to 0 of tan x divided by x, that is also 1, and limit x approaches to 0 of 1 minus cos x divided by x, that becomes 0. E mu result na kalthiddevi. So in this class I am going to discuss about problems on trigonometric functions. So when they given a trigonometric function, how to evaluate the limits, and while evaluating the limit we should always remember 3 results here. Clear? Okay, that is the heading: limits of trigonometric functions. So within that first problem, so what we have here, limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by bx, sin of ax divided by bx. Right, solution: consider the given limit as L. Consider L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by bx. Sin of ax divided by bx. Remember, we have the standard form limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of bx, right? Limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of x divided by x is equal to 1. It means the integral function of sin and the denominators are equal. They are of the same kind. In that case, limit becomes 1. Similarly, here what we have, ax is there. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax is there, divided by bx is there, multiply and divide by a there. Multiply and divide by a. If again agat nodi, L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax is there, alva? Into multiply with a right as it is. This a, what we have here, come to here. So that becomes b into a into x. Group madabodalva. So because they are multiplied here, this is nothing but a into bx agutte, or bx into a, that can be combined as first write b then ax. This is clear here. So I will write this as first write a is a constant, b is also constant. Limit as x approaches to 0 of a divided by b. Remaining terms have with upon them again, sin of ax divided by ax, sin of ax divided by ax. So therefore L becomes, L is equal to a by b is a constant taken from limit, or you can write directly, it is not a problem, a into b, a divided by b into limit x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by ax. Whenever x approaches to 0 at the same time, a into x, that is also approaches to 0, right? That's why sin of ax divided by x. So whenever these are equal, in that case, the limit becomes 1. Therefore, L is equal to, this is here, what we have, a divided by b into, so this term, limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by ax becomes 1. So what is final answer then? L is equal to a divided by b into 1 becomes a by b. This is our required limit. Remember, 3 important result. So then we are evaluating the limit. Just observe madi. Sin of x divided by x is there. Whenever limit x approaches to 0, the value becomes 1. Similarly, suppose it is bx is there divided by bx barbeku. Illi yav term barbutta adhe term barbeku. And here x approaches to, it must be 0. Take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here. Next, dear children, we are moving to the second problem. So here we have limit x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by sin of bx, where a comma b not equal to 0. We have to evaluate this limit. Again, remember the formula: limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax, sin of x divided by x becomes 1. So we go with that one. Solution: consider the given limit as L. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of
sin of ax divided by sin of bx.
Sin of ax divided by sin of bx. To reduce the standard form for this sin of ax, the requirement are ax. Ax must be present in what? Denominator. So, idike maduthiyappa multiply and divide by ax for numerator. Similarly, for if I want to reduce the denominator sin of bx to standard form, here also what we have to multiply and divide by here? Very good, bx. It means for numerator multiply and divide by ax, for denominator multiply and divide by bx. That's will clear the answer. For numerator multiply and divided by ax, and for denominator same, multiply and divide by bx. Multiply and divide by bx, we have to convert to standard form. Therefore, L becomes L now. Now L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0, il nodi sin of ax divided by ax into ax. For numerator we have to multiply and divide by ax. For denominator, what we have, sin bx. For denominator, multiply and divide by what? Bx. Multiply and divide by bx. Now this isn't here. So this is become the standard form, right? Sin of ax divided by ax, when x approaches to 0, the value becomes 1. Similarly for denominator, sin of bx divided by bx, this value also becomes 1. Just observe here, in both the cases here x is common, that's why they get cancelled there. They get cancelled. So whenever limit x approaches to 0, this quantity becomes 1 and this quantity becomes 1. Similarly, we left with here a divided by b. And another thing, here no need of expansion of the limit here. Directly we can apply the limit. Illa mattum step for necessity illa. So limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of ax divided by ax barkanodu into a ide divided by limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of bx divided by bx into b barkanodu, that is not necessary here. So directly you can apply the limit, then find the value. Therefore L is equal to, for this value reduces as what? 1 into a ide numerator denominator. So this value becomes 1 into b. What is final answer? 1 into a is a, 1 into b is b. Therefore L is equal to what? A divided by b. This is our answer. A divided by b. Arthaita makla. So we have to always reduce to standard form. Okay, take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here. Work on makla. Next we are going to the next problem. Third one, evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of, what we have the terms there? Sin of 4x divided by sin of 2x. Sin of 4x divided by sin of 2x. Just previous problem, observe what is sin of ax divided by sin of bx. Here also we go with the same thing there. A replaceable 4 is there, b replaceable 2 is there. For numerator, multiply and divide by 4x. For denominator, multiply and divide by what? 2x. We get the solution. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of 4x divided by sin of 2x. Or else divide both numerator and denominator by x. How come multiply and divide by 4 for numerator and denominator for 2? You will get the answer. So better to, for numerator multiply and divide by 4x, and for denominator multiply and divide by 2x. we get
L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of numerator nodi sine of 4x is there multiply by 4x and divide by 4x whole divided by sine of 2x is there for this term multiply by 2x and divide by 2x
and here x and here x get cancelled this observe here so limit as x approaches to 0 of sine of 4x divided by 4x is there just like ax divided by ax this limit becomes 1 this is also 1 sin of 2x divided by 2x silly integral functions avudirutto ade terms illi irbeku
this is clear okay therefore
now tell me what is the limit then limit of this function no need of exponential derivative can apply the limit here limit of this function becomes 1 into 4 divided by limit as x tend to 0 of this function is 1 into 2 4 ones of 4 divided by 2 1 2 ones of 2 that becomes 2 ones are 2 2 get cancelled therefore L is equal to what is L then L is equal to 2 this is our required limit
arthaitha makkale this is limit as x approaches to sin of 4x divided by sin of 2x is what 2 is our answer
take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here next dear children we are moving to the next problem problem number 4 limit as x approaches to pi of sin of pi minus x divided by pi into pi minus x is there. So whenever you get this kind of function so directly we can change this as x approaches to pi means pi minus x minus pi approaches to 0 with that is one case or else substitute this as another term replace pi minus x as some t or some y at the same time pi minus x also becomes y whenever x approaches to pi if I substitute that as a y y approaches to 0 okay so we will discuss how to solve this problem consider L is equal to limit as x approaches to we have pi sin of pi minus x divided by pi into pi minus x okay put pi minus x is equal to y pi minus x is equal to y okay or you can write here y is equal to pi minus x when x approaches to pi y approaches till nodi when x approaches to pi adaga y approaches to pi minus pi that becomes 0 very good whenever x approaches to pi the y approaches to 0 we are just changing the values so limit as x approaches to pi becomes y approaches to 0 sin of pi minus x is so pi minus x what we taken that as y sin y divided by pi into y pi into y so therefore limit as x approaches to 0 of 1 over pi na baritini first I separate this term then sin of y divided by y now observe here whenever x approaches to 0 1 over pi is a constant and what were the remaining term sin y divided by y there so this can be written as 1 over pi is a constant first write this term then limit as x approaches to 0 of sin y divided by y so that becomes L is equal to 1 over pi into limit as x approaches to 0 sorry y approaches here y approaches to 0 of sin y divided by y therefore L is equal to first term 1 by pi as it is what about rest of the terms here limit as y approaches to 0 of this term becomes 1 into 1 therefore L is equal to 1 by pi this is our required result arthaitha makkala what is our required limit here L is equal to 1 over pi take a pause and note on all the things now dear student we are moving to the next problem problem number 5 So what are the terms here? Evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of 1 cos of 2x minus 1 divided by cos x minus 1.
Okay. Solution. Take the limit as L. Consider L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of cos of 2x minus 1 divided by cos x minus 1. Cos of 2x minus 1 divided by cos x minus 1. For this term, just remember the standard formula. So when we have 1 minus cos x and 1 minus cos of 2x, we have formula, right? So but till namge enidappa cos of 2x minus 1 ide, denominator li cos x minus 1 ide. But the requirement enidide namge 1 minus cos of 2x and 1 minus cos x. For that purpose, multiply and divide by minus 1. Okay. Multiply and divide by minus 1. Therefore, L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of multiply with minus 1. So, minus 1 into cos of 2x minus 1 divided by minus 1 into cos x minus 1. This is limit as x approaches to 0 of multiply with minus 1 there. Minus 1 into cos x minus cos of 2x minus into minus is plus 1 whole divided by similar here also minus cos x plus 1. So rewrite this term as limit as x approaches to 0 of 1 minus cos of 2x divided by 1 minus cos x. Remember the formula. So this formula we are discussing in previous classes. Just go through the formula. So this becomes L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 either, right, as it is, 1 minus cos of 2x can be written as 1 minus cos of 2x can be written as 2 sin square x. Just remember the formula, 2 sin square x, and denominatorly 2, 1 minus cos x becomes 2 sin square x divided by 2. This is the multiple angle, this is the sub multiple or half angle. This is the sin square of x divided by 2. This is the case here. Sin square of x divided by sin square of x divided by 2. Here 2 2 get cancelled. We left it here. Sin square x divided by sin square of x divided by 2. Again, reloading. Sin square of x is there. If I multiply and divide by x square for numerator and for the denominator with the same thing, L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin square of x divided by sin square of x divided by 2 with it. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sin square of x divided by sin square of 2x with it. Sorry, sin square of x by 2. Ali sin square idella pattam idin hege baribodu nodi, multiply and divide by x square, because we have the standard formula for sin x divided by x, because already limit x approaches to enide namge 0. For numerator multiply and divide by x square, for numerator multiply and divide by x square, and for denominator multiply and divided by x by 2 whole square, because we have x by 2, right? Because the degree is 2 for sine. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sine square either. Sine square of x divided by x square into x square whole divided by, for denominator we have to multiply and divide by x by 2 whole square. Sin square of x by 2 divided by x by 2 whole square into x by 2 whole square.
Now we have to combine the terms here.
That L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of ill nodi terms in an agatha. This can be written as sin x divided by x whole square baribodra.
Sin square x divided by x square. So sin x divided by x whole square into x square divided by, this is also sin of x by 2 divided by x by 2 whole square. Whole square.
Okay. Next we left it here. X by 2 whole square becomes x square divided by 4. That is 2 square is 4.
This is clear here. Okay. Next. Nodi. Limit as x approaches to 0 of sin x divided by x in agatappa 1 agatte. But here we have square alva. So that becomes 1 square. Similarly, limit as x approaches to 0 of sin of x by 2 is, remember when x approaches to 0 at the same time x by 2 is also approaches to 0, x divided by 3 is also approaches to 0. Okay, this is the thing. Therefore denominator namage enagutte 1 square. But illi nodi numerator x square idu, illi x square idu, there get cancelled. What is final answer then? So therefore L is equal to, right here L is equal to, so here we have 1 square, denominatorly 1 square into 1 divided by 4. 1 square is 1 divided by 1 square is also 1. That 4 goes to numerator. Therefore, what is final answer? L is equal to 4. This is our final answer. If you want to better understanding, please rewind the things, then revise this one. Take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here. Now, dear students, we are moving to the next problem. Problem number 6. Evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of cos x divided by pi minus x. Cos x divided by pi minus x. Consider the given limit as L. Consider L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of cos x divided by pi minus x. Cos x divided by pi minus x. So directly we can apply the limit as x approaches to 0. Therefore L is equal to, this becomes here cos 0 divided by pi minus 0. L is equal to, cos 0 is 1 divided by pi minus 0. Finally we left with L is equal to 1 over pi. So this is our value. Okay, write on. Now dear students, we are moving to the next problems on trigonometric function. Here we have the 7th problem. Evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of ax plus x into cos x divided by b into sin x. ax plus x into cos x divided by b into sin x. Consider the given limit as L. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of, here what we have here, ax plus x into cos x divided by b into sin x. Just observe in numerator, if observe carefully here, x is common, right? Take x as common. L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of x into, here is a plus cos x divided by, so here b into sin x is there. B into sin x. Okay, now L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 a x into a plus cos x divided by b into sin x. Take this x to denominator. How again agatappa 1 over x agutla denominatorly. Okay, I'll write this as limit as x approaches to 0 of a plus cos x divided by b into, keep write this x in denominator, or take this x to denominator, that becomes sin x divided by x divided by sin x divided by x. Arthaita makla. Okay, then when we are applying limit x tend to 0, this quantity becomes what? Very good, that becomes 1, and cos 0 is 1. Here we left with here a plus 1 divided by b into 1. Therefore L is equal to, whenever limit extend to 0, that becomes a plus cos of 0 divided by
b into 1. Therefore, L is equal to a plus cos 0 is 1 divided by b into 1 is b. That's why, therefore, L is equal to, what is the limit then here? A plus 1 divided by b. This is our limit. Problem is very simple. Just take common term as x, then they take that term to denominator. We got the solution. Okay. Take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here. Now, dear students, we are moving to the problem number 8. Here we have evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of sine of ax plus bx whole divided by ax plus sine of bx, and they give a condition here a comma b and a plus b is not equal to 0. This is clear here. Okay, we'll discuss about this problem. Consider the given limit as L is equal to limit as x approaches to what we have here, 0. This is sine of ax plus bx divided by ax plus sine of bx. So better to take x as a common term in both numerator and denominator. Okay, so again L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of inadi now numerator x na common tagithini. If I take x as common here, this term does not contain x, right? So that's why we have to divide by x. So that becomes sine of ax divided by x plus, here what we taken common as b as common, we left with x as common, we left with b there. And denominatorly, illosti x na common tagothini. If I take x as common, here we left with a plus, this term does not containing any x term, but x is involved in the internal function, right? Not in here. Okay, that's why this can be written as sine of bx divided by x. Sine of bx divided by x, and here x and x get cancelled. Next, L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sine of ax divided by x. Idu observe maadi, denominator namge same term bekalva, illi sine of ax divided by ax idaga directly this limit becomes 1. But what are the requirement here? Only we have here x, but the requirement is ax. So that's why divide and multiply by a there, or multiply and divide by a plus b as it is whole divided by, similar here also a plus sine of bx divided by x is there, multiply and divide by b, multiply and divide by b. So this becomes L is equal to limit as x approaches to 0 of sine of, sorry, combine these two terms here, sine of ax divided by ax into a plus b barithini, denominator lowest, first write a plus sine of bx divided by bx. Combine these two terms here, x into b, that can be written as b into x into b, right, as it is. Clear? Okay, next step nodi, L is equal to ivaga enagutappa limit as x approaches to 0 of this term, what we have here, sine of ax divided by ax becomes, very good, that becomes 1. So that is 1 into a plus b divided by a plus, similarly here also, whenever limit x approaches to 0 of sine of bx divided by bx, that becomes 1, 1 into b. Therefore, L is equal to a plus b divided by a plus b. There get cancelled, we left with 1. Therefore, our required limit L is equal to what? 1. These are things. Concept is very simple here. First, you have to take x as a common in both numerator and denominator. There get cancelled. Then we have to reduce sine of ax divided by x to standard form by multiply and divide by what? A. Then apply the limit. Take a pause and note on all the things what I have written here. Now, dear students, we are moving to the homework problems.
problem number 1, evaluate x approaches to 0 of x into second x. X into second x. So directly we can apply the limit. Whenever x approaches to 0, here we have 0 into second 0. Second 0 becomes 1. 0 into 1 is 0 and answer is 0. And the second question, evaluate limit as x approaches to 0 of cosecant x minus cot x. Cosecant x minus cot x is there. If you apply directly here, x is equal to 0, cosecant 0 becomes infinity and cot 0 is also infinity. This reduces the form infinity minus infinity. This is an indeterminate form. Then how to evaluate this limit? Cosecant can be written as 1 by sine and cot can be written as quotient form cos divided by sine. If you observe carefully, denominator of the same term. So that becomes an LCM. Take LCM, sin x as LCM. 1 minus cos x divided by sin x prut after simplification. 1 minus cos x can be written as 2 sin square x divided by 2. And denominator what we have sin x, that can be written as 2 sin x divided by 2 into cos x divided by 2. Half angle formula for sin x. Then sin sin get cancelled. Directly we can apply the limit, we left it 0. Answer will be 0. And the last question, question number 3. Evaluate limit as x approaches to pi divided by 2. Limit as x approaches to pi divided by 2. So when limit x approaches to pi divided by 2, tan of 2x divided by x minus pi divided by 2. If you apply directly x is equal to pi by 2, tan of 2 into pi by 2, 2 get cancelled, we left with tan pi. Tan pi value is 0. And second term, denominator what we have, x minus pi divided by 2 with. If I replace x is equal to pi by 2, that becomes 0. We left with 0 by 0 form. So for that purpose, for the third question, we have to substitute x minus pi by 2 as y. X minus 2 pi by 2 as y. Whenever x approaches to pi by 2, y approaches to 0. Y and y approaches to 0. Whenever x minus pi by 2 is equal to y, means what is x then? Pi by 2 plus y. Pi by 2 plus y. So replace x is equal to pi by 2 plus y. And the denominator reduces as y directly here. 2 into pi by 2 plus y agutte. So 2 into pi by 2 becomes pi. Pi plus 2 y agutte. Tan of pi plus theta lies in third quadrant. Tan is positive. Okay, we left with tan of 2 y. Multiply and divide by 2, we left with limit as y approaches to 0 of 2 into tan of 2 y divided by 2 y. So both are get. Limit of this form becomes 1 and 2 into 1 is 2 and answer will be 2. This is for last problem. I hope all the problem has been understood here. And the next class, I'm going to discuss about very important problems and limits when the function is split into more than one function, especially mod x, signum x, we discuss in next class. Thank you all.